If anyone wonders, for example, whether newspapers are a thing of the past, all you need to do was to pick up or log on to papers like the Boston Globe.
President Obama talking about the hometown paper at last night's White House Correspondents' Dinner. And joining me now from Boston is Kevin Cullen, columnist for the Boston Globe. Welcome.
Thanks, Howie. I hope he follows that up with a digital subscription.
Yeah.
We need all the dough we can get.
You can send that note to the White House. Now, you had a very richly detailed piece in the paper the other day about the scene at the boat in which Zahar Tsarnaev was captured. And you quote Billy Evans, who was the police supervisor on the scene, yelling, "Hold your fire," and then turning to the SWAT team and saying, "He hurt your guy. Cuff him," before they took him out of that boat. How did you get these police officers and firefighters to recount the story in such graphic detail?
Well, I guess, Howie, the best way to explain it, you know, obviously this was the most followed story, the news story in the last 2 weeks in the world. But for us here at the Boston Globe, it's a local story. So one of the reasons that this had such an impact on me is that I know a lot of these first responders. I mean, I've known them for years. And that's why I think it was a little different. You know, I was in Omagh, Northern Ireland, in 1998 when 28 people and two unborn twins were killed by a bomb. I was in London in 2005 when more than 50 people were murdered by bombs on the tube and a bus. But 2 weeks ago, what happened in my town was deeply personal. And so I think for all my colleagues at the Globe, all of us, this was a professional mission, but it was also a personal mission because we knew people. I know people.
So if I were to ask you, you know, these are brave officers, but if I were to ask you, you know, could they be over-dramatizing or embellishing the account at all, you would say, you know some of these guys and you trust them.
Yeah, oh yeah, absolutely. Yeah, because the other thing is, if they embellish it, they got to live with us the rest of their lives here. So I always say the accountability, the closer you are to things, the more accountability there is. I have no doubt with, if anything, I thought they were understated, the accounts that I was given the other day.
Right. Kevin, you also, in a different column, interviewed the family of Sean Collier. He is the MIT police officer who was killed in the shootout with the older brother. Have people like him gotten enough attention, certainly nationally?
Well, I hope so. I mean, I think Sean Collier was the prototypical policeman, young policeman. He was very idealistic. And when I talked to his brothers and his sisters, they reached out to me. They wanted to talk to me because they wanted me to get this. Everybody knew about him as a police officer, but they really wanted to, as they said, they want to tell Sean's stories and get the full person there. And I hope we accomplished that because he was a wonderful young man. And he was not just admired on that campus, he was deeply loved by the students and the teachers and everybody at MIT.
And yet, as I mentioned a few moments ago, the big stories, the big journalistic firepower, for example, in this morning's New York Times and Washington Post, are these detailed profiles of the Tsarnaev brothers, what happened to them, where they went wrong. I mean, this is, you know, two full pages inside the paper of the Washington Post. Do you want to read these pieces? Do you care about this part of the story?
I mean, I will read them, Howie, but I have to be honest. From the moment those bombs went off, my personal concern and my professional concern were the victims and the first responders. So, I mean, it's going to be easy for me to forget these guys because I can't pronounce their names. But I want people to know names like Sean O'Brien, a firefighter who raced to the scene, Danny Linsky, the superintendent and chief of the police here in Boston, who's no desk jockey, who was on the streets when this stuff was going down early Friday morning. I want people to remember the women from the police women from District 4, not too far from here, who went toward the bombs. When the bombs started going off, those police women went toward the victims. I want them to remember those names. I want them to remember, the Watertown police officers who responded to this. Johnny McClellan, Jeff Pugliese, the sergeant who brought the suspect down. Joe Reynolds, the police officer who came across them. Those are the names that Americans should remember because they are, I think the word hero is used too often, and very often it's devalued. But what our first responders here, the firefighters, the police officers, the emergency medical services people here, I don't know how to call what they did other than heroic.
Is there any danger because it's local and you know these people and you are obviously emotional about it that you're sort of too close to the story and that would affect your telling of it?
Maybe. That brings pluses and minuses with it, I guess. You know, I'm a columnist. I'm entitled to engage in opinion. But I got to tell you, you know, this wasn't, I mean, we're talking about me. The Boston Globe as an institution really stepped up and I think showed its indispensability. I've listened for years, people telling that we're dinosaurs, that we're going to go away. I think the last 2 weeks have shown more than anything, newspapers like the Boston Globe are vital because we are part of this community. And that attack on the Marathon was not just an attack on Boston, it was an attack on all of us, and we responded in kind. Woody Allen said 80% of life is showing up. Well, the Boston Globe showed up.
I'm going to agree with you on that point. The Boston Globe showed up. Boston Globe also got millions of visitors to its website because it dropped its paywall because of the magnitude of this event. And I think some of what you've said here today shows you the value of not just reporters who know the community, but reporters who live in the community and bring that emotional attachment. Kevin Cullen, thanks very much for joining us from Boston.
Thanks, Howie.